great rivalry between yourself and Roger Aiken today, and it's a toss-up between the two of you. How are you feeling?
I'd say it'll come down probably between the two of us. There's a bit of a gap behind us, but you know, the other guys are chasing obviously hard too. I don't know. You never know until the event actually gets going and see how your legs are feeling, see how you're riding. But yeah, Roger's been riding really well this year, so they expect him to be really in good form here today anyway. So, but sure, we give it our best shot anyway, then that's all we can do.
Roger Aiken! John Boots! Peter McCombo! One foot on the ground, guys! Up, 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 up!
Yeah, I mean, it's probably the best park in Dublin for doing these kind of events outside the Phoenix Park. It's a huge area, great trails, great tracks, and really good mixture between tarmac and off-road. It perfectly suits cross for that reason.
There's obviously a double sword out there. It's Roger Aiken and it's Robin Seymour.
Really, if you're going to go on results, it'd be Roger or Robin you'd call, but Matt's definitely a new contender and coming up as well. Robin's 18 titles in the last 20 years. The only other person to take those titles is Roger when he's raced, and then Joe McCall 1 year when neither of the guys raced.
Second last lap, what's happening?
Basically, Roger and Robin have been fighting it out for the last six laps. Robin's got a pretty commanding lead at this stage. Roger's about 10-15 seconds behind him, and then about another 10 seconds behind that, We have Matt Adair from Banbridge as well, so kind of tight, but it looks like Robin's going to pull off the 18th win now.
Roger had an issue in the woods, his chain popped off.
Yeah, apparently both Roger and Matt Adair lost their chain, so it's going to mean that, you know, Smart Racer would attack at that point. May or may not happen, didn't see it. But it's definitely a gap developed after the third lap, and probably due to mechanical for both the lads.
Sailing in the bag, a great race. Roger had issues in the woods, but you were strong. You looked great. People said that you looked well on that bike, strong as ever.
Yeah, no, it was great. It went really well. I think Roger slipped his chain off top of one of the run-ups, and that's just the opportunity I wanted, you know. And you know, you get a 5 or 10 second gap then, and then you're going to really work and really manage it from there. Like, it's. It was very hard for about 4 or 5 laps, and it was just toing and froing, a second here, a second there, and it's not very much, but it's quite good because the course is quite good because you can see lots of gaps. You can see the gaps at many points on the lap. You know, you can see if you pulled out a bit of time from lap to lap, but so there were sections on the lap that I'd have pulled the gap and he'd close back in another section, and you'd be just like, oh, keep the head down, you know, keep pushing.
Seymour champion, thanks so much.
Thanks very much.